In this illustration, we'll analyze the acceleration of a falling rod. Here, the figure shows a uniform rod AB of mass M and length L placed vertically on a rough ground, and we are given that its upper end is tapped slightly so that it starts falling, and there is sufficient friction present at its lower end so that it does not slip. And we are required to find the acceleration of rod center of mass when it is at an angle theta to the vertical during motion. So, in this case, if we draw the position of rod when it is at an angle theta to vertical, then you can say it has fallen to this position to an angle theta. And at this position, it is experiencing a weight in downward direction, a normal reaction in upward direction, and friction in horizontal direction. In this case, due to its free fall on ground, we can say it has attained an angular speed omega and angular acceleration alpha. Then we can calculate the value of omega by work energy theorem. So we can write, by work energy theorem, we use the distance by which its center of mass has fallen is L by 2, 1 minus cos theta. So we can write mg L by 2, 1 minus cos theta is equals to half ml square by 3 multiplied by omega square, which gives us the value of omega. This root of 3g by L multiplied by 1 minus cos theta. And we have got the value of omega, and angular acceleration we can calculate by Newton's law. We use in this situation, the torque acting on the rod about this end point B is mg multiplied by this L by 2 sine theta. So we can write it as L by 2 sine theta is equals to this ml square by 3 multiplied by alpha, which gives us the angular acceleration of rod, that is 3g sine theta by 2l. And using omega and alpha, we can calculate the acceleration of the center of mass of the rod. One is in tangential direction, which is at, and other is in normal direction, which is an. So in this situation, we can write the tangential acceleration of a rod center is, here we can write the tangential acceleration, we can write as L by 2 alpha. So in this situation, when we substitute the value of alpha, this is giving us 3 by 4 g sine theta, that is the tangential acceleration. And if we calculate the normal acceleration of a rod center is, normal acceleration is due to the circular motion of the center, and as its angular speed is omega, this given by omega square L by 2. So if we substitute the value of normal acceleration we are getting after putting the value of omega over here is 3 by 2 g multiplied by 1 minus cos theta. So as we have got the tangential and normal acceleration of center, then we can write total acceleration of rod center is, this total acceleration is given by root of a tangential square plus a normal square. Now we can substitute both of these terms over here, and when you simplify these terms, the final result you'll get is 3g by 4 multiplied by under the root 5 plus 3 cos square theta minus 8 cos theta. This will be the result of this problem. And this you can obtain by substituting AT and AN over here and simplifying the relation.